Welcome to this complete tutorial on anything you need to know about variable data in Adobe Photoshop. We will be going from a spreadsheet to an end result in three different extensions. Let's get started with setting up the main document. So you start off with the background and then you're going to add the text layers. These text layers will be replaced with the data in your spreadsheet. For the visualization, I named this variable 1, 2, and 3, but you can name it whatever you want. Make sure that the text layers are separate to import the data. In this example, variable 3 will contain more data than 1 and 2, so I made 3 a text box. If you don't know how to do it, just select the text tool and drag a box to the size that you would like it to be. For the pixel layer, it is very important to rasterize the pixel layer. If you don't do that, you will not be able to select the pixel variable later on. I already dragged in an example picture to set a box size for all the images to import. You have multiple options on how the variable image must respond to this box size. We will get to that later. Okay, so now that the main document is set up, we are going to define the variables. Go to Image, Variables, Define. In here, we can select our 3 text layers and 1 image layer. We are starting with the first layer and select text replacement. The name that Photoshop will give to this variable must be the same as you use as the header in your spreadsheet. So continue to do this for variable 2 and 3. For the pixel layer, the name will be pixel variable 1. So again, make sure the header of the spreadsheet is the same. These are the different options we have to how the images must respond to the original box size as set in the main document. When you choose fit, the image will fit in the original box without messing up the width and height ratio. Fill will also keep the ratio, but the image can be bigger than the box. As is, we'll just place the original image and just center it in the middle of the box. And the last one, conform, will change your image exactly to the box size without paying attention to the ratio of your image. In this tutorial, I will choose fit, and I think in most cases that fit is the best option to choose. Okay, so now we have defined the variables and we will start importing the datasets. To do so, we're going to Google Spreadsheet and see how we build the variables in the spreadsheet. To open up Google Spreadsheet, you go to spreadsheet.google.com. From here, we can open a new document. The reason why I choose Spreadsheet instead of Excel is that Excel gives an error message when importing the CSV file most of the times. If you already built your data in Excel, then you can just simply copy and paste it in a spreadsheet. Okay, so let's have a look at a spreadsheet that I have already created. The most important thing in this document is that the first row is used for the variable names. So here we got variable 1, 2, and 3, and the pixel variable in the first row. The other rows will be the data sets. Now for the text variables, you can just simply fill in or import the text you need. For the pixel variable, we need the path of the image on your computer. To do so, we're going over to the map that contains the images on the computer. So here we are at the map. In my case, it contains all the country flags we're going to use. To copy the path, we're going to select all, then hold shift and right click on the mouse. When you hold shift and right click, the option copy as path will appear and you can click it. When you paste it, it can mess up the alphabetical order a bit, so keep that in mind. Okay, the document is complete, so now we can export it as a CSV file. Go over to File, choose Download, and download it as a CSV file. After the document is saved, we're going back to Photoshop to import it. In the variable window, we're going to select Datasets and click on Import. Make sure you select the CSV file instead of the TXT file. Select the document and the data will be imported. You can select Replace existing datasets. That's it, now the data is imported and we can swap between the datasets. Select Preview to see the results. Now you can check and make sure that the data is imported correctly. Hit OK and it will take you back to the main document. From here on, we're going to save all the datasets as documents. To save it as PSD files, you click on Export and choose Datasets as Files. Make sure All Datasets is selected. Here we can decide how the export names must be built. This works fine for me, but you can choose other options if needed. Now select the output folder and hit OK. When we go to the map, we see that Photoshop exported all the datasets. And that is pretty much it when you only need the PSD files. But I will show you how to export to JPEG and PDF as well. For the JPEG, go to File, Script and choose the Image Processor. Here you must select the folder where the PSD files are located. I always set the quality to 12 because that's the maximum quality you can get. Now you can simply hit run and the files will be saved. When it's done, you head back to your map and you see that the .jpeg folder is created. Okay, for this final part of the video, we're going to see how we save the files as PDF files. Head over to File, Automate and choose PDF Presentation. Click on Browse and select the PSD files we have just created. You can sort them by name if you want to keep the alphabetical order. And also important, make sure nothing is included in the file, because when you include something, you will get a white border. So when all that is set, we're going to click Save and the PDF file will be saved. I hope you all enjoyed it and feel free to ask me about the subject in the comments.